Greetings. I recently posted a comment under a Christian video. It resulted in a conversation thread that I had with a Muslim. In the thread, I did not take the time to provide the scriptural evidence to support my assertions. I'll do that here after the thread. My posts will be in light blue. The responses will be in yellow. The only thing we may know about Jehovah God is what He reveals about Himself. He has done this by the prophets, from Adam to Jesus, who declared He was the Son of God, foretold by the prophets of Jehovah God. Prophets Malachi, Isaiah, David, and John all reveal the Son of God, and even more, Jehovah God coming to His temple. What the difference between Him and another prophets? Greetings. I think the biggest confusion is that a king can send his son as a messenger. The role being filled does not change the relationship to the king. In the same way, God can send his son as a messenger or a prophet. The role of messenger does not change the relationship of Yeshua to his father. In the same way, the Son of God came as the Messiah that God had promised. Prophet Daniel said the Messiah would die for the sins of his people. This is why Yeshua was crucified during Passover. Messiah was the sacrifice that God provided for himself. There are several other things critical in the message of the prophets, such as that God would send His Son. And when Yeshua walked on earth, God spoke from the clouds and said Yeshua was His Son. So He is not God, was the Muslim's reply. Actually, the prophets prove Yeshua is God, brother. A false prophet denies that Jesus is God. Give me only one verse that he said he is God. I was a bit slow and misread his question as, give me one verse that proves he is God. So I answered the wrong question. Malachi 3:1, God will send a prophet before he comes to his temple. The prophet to prepare the way for Jehovah God is John the Baptist. And then I went back and reread his actual question. Give me only one verse that he said he is God. I just reread your question. You are asking the DDAT question where Jesus said, I am God, worship me. And I gave him a link to one of my videos where I address this jihad. Where did Jesus say, I am God, worship me? A Christian answer. I recommend you watch it if you have not. Briefly summarized, Jesus said, I am the Son of God, and they tried to stone him. Later, Jesus said, I have many things to tell you that you cannot bear at this time. What could possibly be more shocking than, I am the Son of God? Let's go through my answers and examine the scriptural justification for each. The only thing we may know about Jehovah God is what He reveals about Himself. 1 Corinthians 2:6. Among the mature, however, we speak a message of wisdom, but not the wisdom of this age or of the rulers of this age who are coming to nothing. No, we speak of the mysterious and hidden wisdom of God, which He destined for our glory before time began. God's wisdom is hidden, but we can now speak of it because He has shared it with us. None of the rulers of this age understood it, for if they had, they would not have crucified the Lord of glory. This passage speaks regarding our knowledge of God's plans. In fact, those that crucified Jesus did not know that was God's plan. Rather, as it is written, no eye has seen, no ear has heard, no heart has imagined what God has prepared for those who love Him. This comes from Isaiah 64:4. For since the beginning of the world, men have not heard, nor perceived by the ear, nor has the eye seen. O God, beside thee, what he or what you have prepared for him that waits for him. No one other than God knew God's plan. We can only know God's plan when God reveals it to us. But God has revealed it to us by His Spirit. The Spirit searches all things, even the deep things of God. In the Old Testament, the Spirit revealed it through prophets. In the New Testament, the Holy Spirit reveals it directly to Christians. John 16:12, I have yet many things to say unto you, but you cannot bear them now. Howbeit, when He, the Spirit of truth, is come, He will guide you into all truth. For He shall not speak of Himself, but whatsoever He shall hear, that shall He speak, and He will show you things to come. This is not another man, another prophet. This Spirit knows God's secrets. He shall glorify me, for he shall receive of mine and shall show it unto you. All things that the Father has are mine. Therefore said I, that he shall take of mine and shall show it unto you. But God has revealed it to us by the Spirit. The Spirit searches all things, even the deep things of God. For who among men knows the thoughts of man except his own spirit within him? So too, no one knows the thoughts of God except the Spirit of God. And God has revealed it to us by the Spirit that searches all things, even the deep things of God. The natural man does not accept the things that come from the Spirit of God, for they are foolishness to him, and he cannot understand them because they are spiritually discerned. This passage has talked about the Spirit of God, but Didat, a Muslim, tries to claim Muhammad, a mere man, is the Spirit of God. But a man, a natural man, cannot be the Spirit of God. So the only thing we may know about Jehovah God is what He reveals about Himself. And God has revealed it to us by the Spirit who searches all things, even the deep things of God. He has done this by the prophets from Adam to Jesus. This is an example. Habakkuk 1:1. The following is the message which God revealed to Habakkuk the prophet. Another example, Isaiah 13:1. This is an oracle concerning Babylon that Isaiah, son of Amoz, received. Malachi 1:1. This is an oracle, the word of the Lord of Israel through Malachi. Daniel 9:2. During the first year of his reign, I, Daniel, learned from reading the word of the Lord, as revealed to Jeremiah the prophet, that Jerusalem must lie desolate for 70 years. 2 Chronicles 36:21. So the land enjoyed its Sabbath rest all the days of the desolation until 70 years were complete, in fulfillment of the word of the Lord through Jeremiah. Hebrews 1:1. On many past occasions and in many different ways, God spoke to our fathers through the prophets. But in these last days, He has spoken to us by His Son, whom He appointed heir of all things and through whom He made the universe. Was Jesus a prophet? Absolutely. Jesus even referred to himself as a prophet. Mark 6:4, and Jesus said to them, a prophet is not without honor, except in his hometown and among his relatives and in his household. Luke 24:27, and beginning with Moses and all the prophets, He explained to them what was written in all the scriptures about himself. Deuteronomy 18:15, "The Lord thy God will raise up unto thee a prophet from the midst of thee, of thy brethren like unto me," meaning Moses. "Unto him you shall hearken." Deuteronomy 18:18, this is God speaking, repeating what Moses just said. "I will raise up a prophet from among their brethren, like unto thee, and will put my words in his mouth, and he shall speak unto them all that I shall command him." Matthew 21:11, the crowds replied, "This is Jesus, the prophet from Nazareth in Galilee." So was Jesus a prophet? Absolutely. We know absolutely Jesus was the prophet of Deuteronomy 18. He has done this by the prophets from Adam to Jesus, who declared he was the Son of God. Hebrews 1:2, "But in these last days he has spoken to us by his Son." Romans 1:4, "And was declared to be the Son of God with power, according to the Spirit of holiness, by his resurrection from the dead, Jesus Christ our Lord." Even Jesus personally declared he was the Son of God. John 10:36, "Do you say of him whom the Father consecrated and sent into the world, you are blaspheming, because I said I am the Son of God?" When Jesus declared he was the Son of God, they tried to kill him. He declared he was the Son of God, foretold by the prophets of Jehovah God. Isaiah 7:14, "Therefore the Lord himself will give you a sign. Behold, the virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and shall call his name Emmanuel," which means God with us. Isaiah 9:6, "For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government will be upon his shoulders, and he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace." Psalm 2:7, "I will declare the decree the Lord has said to me, Thou art my son, this day have I begotten thee." Proverbs 30:4, "Who has ascended into heaven and descended? Who has gathered the wind in his fists? Who has wrapped the waters in his garments? Who has established all the ends of the earth? What is his name, or his son's name? Surely you know." Yes, we know his name, Jehovah, and his son's name, Yeshua, the Son of God, foretold by the prophets of Jehovah God, out of the mouths of three prophets in four places. Prophets Malachi, Isaiah, David, and John all reveal the Son of God, and even more, Jehovah God coming to his temple. Malachi 3:1, "Behold, I will send my messenger." Jehovah, God speaking here through prophet Malachi. Jehovah will send his prophet. "Behold, I will send my messenger who will prepare the way." The purpose of this prophet is to make preparations, to prepare the way. But prepare what? For who? "Who will prepare the way before me." Me is a self-referential pronoun, meaning the speaker is referring to himself. Jehovah God speaking here through Malachi. So Jehovah is saying he will send a prophet to prepare the way for him, God. Isaiah 40:3, "The voice of him that crieth in the wilderness, prepare ye the way of the Lord." That's Jehovah, the Tetragrammaton. "Make straight in the desert a highway for our God." Isaiah repeats this description of the voice or the prophet who will prepare the way for Jehovah God. John 1:23, John replied in the words of Isaiah the prophet, I am the voice of one calling in the wilderness. Make straight the way for the Lord. John the Baptist claimed for himself that he was the prophet to prepare the way for Jehovah God. Luke 3:4, as it is written in the book of the words of Isaiah the prophet, a voice of one calling in the wilderness, prepare the way for the Lord, make straight paths for him. Matthew 3:3, for this is he that was spoken of by the prophet Esaias, saying, the voice of one crying in the wilderness, prepare ye the way of the Lord, make his paths straight. All four Gospels record this meaning, and the fulfillment of Malachi 3:1 and Isaiah 40 verse 2. To summarize, let's read Mark's record of this message. Mark 1:1, the beginning of the Gospel of Jesus Christ, the Son of God. If you are Muslim, this is the basis, the beginning of the Gospel, the Injil, as it is written in the prophets. The Gospel begins with the prophets and is in total agreement with the prophets. Behold, I send my messenger before thy face, which shall prepare thy way before thee. Say hello to Malachi 3:1. The good news begins here. Mark 1:3. The voice of one crying in the wilderness, prepare ye the way of the Lord, make his paths straight. Say hello to Isaiah 40, verse 3. The gospel, the good news, the Injil, stands on Isaiah 40, verse 3. Behold, I will send my messenger who will prepare the way before me. Then the Lord whom you seek will suddenly come to his temple. The Lord is coming to his temple. Whose temple? God's temple. God is going to come to his temple. Logic would be prone to link the individual who showed up as the one who promised he was coming. If the message prophets Malachi, Isaiah, and John relayed a message that identified God coming to his temple? When God shows up, does God need to say, I am God? Give that some thought, and I'll continue providing scriptural support in the next video. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.